Well, out they come. This promises to be a real corker of a match. Italy v. France. Both of these teams are very lively, to put it mildly. For France, we've got Anas Anan, Jean-Paul Antoine de Belleval, Valerian Castanet, and in reserve it will be Adrian Springer, Spickinger. And for Italy, it'll be Giulio Lombardi, Damiano Di Baroli, Tommaso Martini, and Jacopo Bonato in reserve. Our officiating crew for tonight, Miguel Machado of Portugal, Eugene Weihong Chua of Singapore, Huang Hao Chi of Taipei, and Alexei Kuznetsov of Canada. So I'm just looking here at how these teams got here, and I need to go back, I think, to the 32, because Italy started off the day against Argentina. Then they had an interesting match against Israel, who had knocked out Egypt, and then they got Slovakia, because Ukraine had been knocked out. And then, of course, a match against Poland. And here we are. France number 3 seed took out Denmark in the 16. Uzbekistan in a sweat-free match in the quarterfinals, and then a barn burner of a match against Hungary with bodies flying and things getting knocked over. But here we are, and it will be Tommaso Lombardi, Di Baroli to start for Italy. Martini will open, Martini will close for Italy, and Castanet will open for France. De Belleval will close, and Miguel Machado, our referee for the first two legs. This is what we're gonna get. Parry and a flick across the back, and then turning to get the cheers from the crowd. And that's a good thing. Big old counterattack there from Valerian Castanet. They're both off target there. Still, Martini's attack, preparation, Castagny. And he stepped in, stopped. Perry riposte, and Stefano Ceriani up, fist pumping. Five, one to open. We go to the second. And it will be Giulio Lombardi on with his beach hair. And Paul Antoine de Belval for France. Nice looking counter, but out of time. Still de Belval's attack. Lombardi looking for the blade. Mask clip was, no, it wasn't undone, it was just interfering with the target. It was Lombardi's undone. Attack off target. Lombardi looking for kind of a ducking counter type thing. De Belval having nothing of it. Lombardi's attack off target. Oh, nice parry there from Lombardi. But only one so far in this for him. And up. The target score here is 10, so this can run for a bit, at least as long as the clock allows. A little too much preparation to Belval. Lombardi with the attack. Of target. The ball in with the counter. Pick up the blade there from Lombardi, but no light of any kind on that exchange. And that will do it, 7-6. So two in that for Lombardi. And five for De Belval. Damiano Di Veroli on for Italy. And it will be Anas Anan, I think bronze medalist from two nights ago. One for France. And it is Eugene Chua of Singapore, our referee for the next two legs. Thank you. None. Off target. Completely. Almost unhinged. Running at top speed all the way down the piste. To be parried. To be parried off target. Yeah, nice, nice parry from DiVaroli. Massive attack. DiVaroli is really putting his stamp on this here. That's one way to do it. Okay. Actually, it's a very good way to do it. Okay. DiVaroli surrenders his weapon. He'll get a new one. Sticky point is a distraction. Oh, no, not this again. Final action. Parry, riposte, Damiano DiVaroli. There's a video review. But there seems to have been a slight momentum shift with the arrival of Mr. DiVaroli. Parry, riposte, touche. Well, Deverolli, as we get fist pumping and box pounding from Stefano Cheriani and crew, Deverolli has really shifted gears here. Still 11 seconds. To take it to the target score, not that it's important. Start the clock. Now they have. Now, that's done it. 14 for Italy, 7 for France, 7 in the third for Damiano Deverolli, 1 for Anna Sanan. And we'll go into the fourth. Giulio Lombardi is back on for Italy. He had only 2 in his first outing. See how he gets on here against Valeri and Castagny, who actually only had 1 in his first outing. Final action. Parry, riposte off target. Lombardi. First attack was no. Counter puts Italy up by 8. Interesting counter. Castagny surrenders his weapon, and he looks like he might be just a little frustrated and even stressed. Okay, new weapon in hand. Valerian Castagny comes out full of hope. Another deadly counterattack from Lombardi. And the target here is 20 in the fourth. Right. Hardy. Off target on that attack. Oh. Castanet on the board for the first time in this leg. Some really nice counterattacks from Lombardi in this fourth leg. They're having a look at the video. I think the Italian box is concerned that the score wasn't right, but it is right. It is correct. Castanet steps in, stops, and Lombardi goes. Nice quick attack there from Castanet, but it's only a second. And this fourth leg is all done for. 19 for Italy. 9 for France. 5 in that for Giulio Lombardi, 2 for Valerian Castanet. We go to the fifth, and it will be Tommaso Martini back on for Italy, and he will face Anas Anand of France. And this could be interesting. Preparation from Anand, and Martini takes immediate advantage. Well, Anand has his weapon checked. I That was a darn fine counterattack from Tommaso Martini. Stepping in. The blocking counter. And it's kind of going from bad to worse for France here. But Italy looks great. Puts together, or Anand puts together an attack. A minute and 14 seconds into this fifth leg. Second. Oh, lovely. Like ballet. Perfect parry and a perfect riposte. So two in that. Yeah, I was going to say, what happened to the score? Okay, so 25-11. That's more like it. Only two in that for Anand. Five for, no, six for Tommaso Martini. And into the sixth we go with Damiano Di Veroli and Paul Antoine de Belva. A nice tech there from DeBelleval. There from DeBelleval, but France, you know, we're into the sixth now. Italy has been productive in every leg, and France is not. And I think the last time that France was actually productive in this entire match was in the second leg, and it was Paul-Antoine DeBelleval. Say it looks like Di Veroli has surrendered his weapon. We'll get a new one. Lightning fast, direct attack, Di Veroli. Di Veroli off target. A very nice counterattack. Nice block out there from DeBelleval. And tech off target. Thank you. What was that? It's actually a big scoreboard between me and the French end of the piste. And how he managed to go tumbling off that, I have no idea. Clock will wind down and take us to the end of the sixth leg. 28 for Italy, 16 for France, so 5 in it for de Belval, and that's 3 in it for Di Veroli. So interestingly, so it's a plus 2 there for de Belval and a minus 2 for Di Veroli. And the last time, there have only been, out of 6 legs played, there have only been 2 times when France has had the upper hand in terms of individual score, and they were both de Belval. Going into the 7th, we'll have Giulio Lombardi back on for his final appearance against Anas Anand. This is not Anand. It is Adrian Spiekiger, the reserve. Counter off target there from Lombardi. Nice duck and counter there from Lombardi. Spiekiger's certainly come out full of energy and trying to light a fire under this French side. Still Lombardi's attack off target.
Okay.
Well, that was just an unbeatable parry and riposte. Oh, Lombardi going for a duck and counter. Well, he got the duck, and he actually got the duck right, but he couldn't get the counter part of it down. And Spiekiger takes one step back and launches a reprise of the attack. Okay, well, he got the counterpart right there. Okay, now he put both of them together, the duck and the counter. Well, that counter will do it with the seventh leg, and I think that there's probably a counterattack showreel out of this match. 35-21, so 5 in it for Spiekiger and 7 for Giulio Lombardi. Damiano Di Viroli on in the 8th to face Valerian Castagny. So Lombardi, 2-5, finishes with a +2 indicator. Spiekiger finishes with a -2. And Anand finished with a -10 indicator.
Right?
I think this whole match is actually a counterattack masterclass. Oh my. It took the blade, flicked to the back. And just throw in a simple direct attack to top things off. And that will do it for the eighth, 40 for Italy, 21 for France, 5 in it for Divaroli, nil point for Valerian Castagny. We go into the ninth and final leg. And it will be Tommaso Martini on to close for Italy and Paul-Antoine de Belleval for France. So Divaroli. Yes. 6. Divaroli finishes on a plus 9 indicator. And de Belleval. Trying to do as much as he can, as quickly as he can. Destiny. Castagny finishes on a minus 9 indicator. Well, Paul-Antoine de Belleval is, I presume, going to make a run at this, like a serious run. Martini has surrendered his weapon to get a new one. But de Belleval is the only person on this French squad tonight that has been able to get any kind of result against Italy. We're going to have a video review here. Not so much how did he turn his back, but how much did he turn his back? My. What an exchange. What an exchange with no result. DeVille Hall asked for a video review. He wants every hit. We've got this thing going on, especially when France is on the piste, where it's kind of like people are shouting across the arena to each other, like, what's your name? And somebody shouts back, Tony! That's not what they're saying. Well, there is a world of time on the clock. He's not letting even a spare second get away from him, DeBell Fall. And he is now on a card for ducking his head. Nice parry there from Tommaso Martini. Yeah. His teammates doing the can-can. Oh. Oh my. That would have been a way to win, to end it, add insult to injury, but that was still DeBell Fall's attack. Well, Martini asked for a video review. Martini looking for the showboat finish here. Be careful here. He's on a card, and we've seen two matches end today on cards. He got it. He got his showboat shot to finish this match. That was pretty wild stuff. 45-28. Seven in that for DeBellaval. He's the only French fencer on this squad in positive numbers, I believe. And what was that? That was five for Martini. So minus two for Martini there. That's four. So plus six indicator for Tommaso Martini. Oh, by the way, congratulations to our 2022 junior men's foil team world champions, Italy. Okay. Now let's see. Castany. I mean, ball plus three. Plus two. So, DeBellaval on a plus seven indicator. Didn't help though. Congratulations, Italy. That was just that was almost perfect.